Hi, this is Anna with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to do a little color correction and also smoothing to a photograph. And the reason you might want to do this, a lot of times with, say, acne or something like that, you can fix this with lighting. I downloaded this photo from Pexels, and you can get the link in the description if you want to practice with this photo. But sometimes just based on the lighting, it's going to catch certain parts of the face in an unflattering way. You can do a lot of fixing of this in Photoshop, and I want to show you kind of some ways of fixing some of the reddish color that's on this guy's face, and also maybe just minimizing some of the acne that he has. I don't think it makes sense to get rid of it completely. You don't want to go too far and have someone be completely different. You want to still maintain the look of their face and everything, but you want to edit the face so that it turns out as if it would if, you know, the lighting were just a little brighter and it would have blown out some of those areas. Let's go ahead and copy this layer. We can just pull this down to the new layer icon. Got two copies of the photo now. And now hit Command I to invert that layer. You can also go up to Image, Adjustments, and Invert right here. Now I realize it looks a little crazy, but we're gonna keep going. Let's go ahead and change this normal setting here to Vivid Light. This is still looking pretty weird, so let's go ahead and go to Filter, Other, and High Pass. And now we can see a little bit more of what's going on. I want this part to be smooth enough so that it'll look better, but not too smooth. So I'm going to leave it right at about 9.1 and say OK. And then we'll go to Filter and Gaussian Blur. And usually I do about half of what that last setting was. So that was 9.1. So we'll put it at 4.5 here and say OK. Now let's do Option and click the Layer Mask button. And now we can paint on this layer. So let's zoom in pretty close with the Z tool. And now I'm going to get a brush. I'm going to hit B for the brush tool. We want the size to be right about this big and the hardness to be 0. So not hard at all, very soft brush. Make sure white is your fill color, but we can paint on with the brush that smoothness. And we can also minimize some parts that we don't want to stand out as much. So I'm gonna paint over here and kind of just smooth out some of the cheek things right here besides the nose. And anywhere you don't want shine to be also, this will help to fix it. Maybe some of these down here. I know it might be a little hard to see where my mouse is. Maybe we'll get that. You can also hold down Control and Alt to resize your mouse and resize the hardness. I'm just going to kind of get a lot of these little spots out, and then we'll switch over to removing the redness. Okay, so I think this is pretty good. If we turn this layer off, we can see the change. It's really subtle, but I think it does improve the look a little bit. Okay, now to remove the redness, create a new layer, and then we'll change the blending mode to color. That's right down here at the bottom. And then we can grab a brush with 100% opacity, but a 10% flow. So I'm gonna hit B to get the brush tool. And we'll do normal brush here. We'll do 100% opacity and a 10% flow. And now click Option to get a skin color that you like that's nearby the red. So I'm going to hit Option and sample this right here. And now I can paint over the redness and we'll see how that looks. It looks like it's turning it a little bit gray. Maybe we won't do that color. I'm gonna undo. Let's do this yellowish over here and we'll paint over now. Okay, and that's a little more what I'm looking for. Over here, we'll choose this yellowish here. And that gives us a little more of an orange look instead of the red. And I'll choose this color up here. It does sometimes want to go gray on you, so you have to be careful about that. But I think it does a pretty good job of of reducing the red without losing a skin tone color. Another thing this is really good for is if he is wearing, say, like a green shirt and you're wanting to change the color of the green shirt to yellow, you'll still have a green cast on his skin, and you can do the same trick to help change that to more of a skin tone. Okay, so let's take a look at what we've got now. I'm going to turn off these two layers and you can see what we started with and what we finished with. Now, you do have to be careful getting it a little too smooth. I probably went a little overboard on the numbers that I did with my background copy here. So be careful about that. You don't want it to look, obviously, Photoshopped. So go ahead and play around with those until you get it right. But you can always knock down the opacity of this layer too to bring back some of the stuff from the background layer if it is too overwhelming. Let me know in the comments section if you have any tricks yourself about removing color cast or smoothing skin. I would love to hear them. Thank you, and I'll see you next week for another video.